Here's how to create consistent characters, consistent backgrounds, and a full visual story from just one single image. If you're a filmmaker, a creative director, a photographer, I'm going to walk you through how I generated this entire sequence using AI with perfect character and background consistency. You know, you don't need to be tech savvy to be able to do this. Take a look at all these shots. Every single one of them is 100% AI generated. I was never photographed in this setting. This entire scene was generated with a single source image and a consistent prompt flow. And for a second, let's just appreciate the quality. This is where AI is at today, my friend. 100% AI. No camera, no studio, no location shoot. The character is consistent, the background is consistent, the story flows frame to frame. This is what's possible when you combine smart prompting with the smart tools, and it's opening up new ways to create story-driven content with AI. Today, I want to show you how you can achieve this type of results simply by mastering prompting, and I want to break down to you the video that I just showed. But why does this matter? Well, as filmmakers, creative directors, photographers, we know that the visual consistency, the visual continuity is everything. In film, we hire script supervisors. In photography, you lock down lighting, the wardrobe, the camera settings. In AI, though, well, that's a moving target. AI models don't really care about consistency. They care about generating something new all the time. You cannot control it. But here's the thing. When you can control consistency, when you can design a character that feels anchored in a world that moves through the frames with some sort of believable continuity, you start to create visual narratives that can rival traditional production pipelines. And here's where you get valued, my friend. Here's where you will start monetizing. Because like I've said before, consistency and realism equals money. And here's what I'm going to show you today. Not just going to talk to you about how to use the tools, but also I'll try and help you to think like an art director when building AI-driven storylines. So let's get started. Step number one, generate your character and source image. The very first thing that you need when building any visual storyline is a strong character. And, of course, with AI, a strong source image. So for this, I'm using Google's new image model, ImageN4, which you can find inside Whisk AI. Here's our playground. Now, let's generate an image. As you can see, I've already created a few examples here, but notice that most of them are close-ups, and this is intentional. This is a key part of the process. You want your character to occupy a very good portion of the frame. But here's what also you need to consider. First, you need to choose frontal readable expressions because these are the easiest to maintain consistency. Second, you need to ensure costume details are visible. Let's say folds, textures, accessories, or anything that you want the character to wear throughout the entire scene. And number three, you need to control the background. Is there anything particular that's happening in the background? Do we need that for our continuity? Do we need that in our variation? Think about that. Now, here's my prompt for this image that I want to generate. A moody, photorealistic close-up photograph of a model in a foggy forest. The background is softly blurred with a faint silhouette of a distant castle visible through the mist. Cinematic lighting, shallow depth of field, natural skin texture. This is good. I'm going to hit generate, but more importantly than the words that we are using is the intent. What is the story? What are you trying to tell? What is the mood? What world is this character living in, right? Now, before we hit generate, we want to make sure that in our settings, we have chosen best quality over here and hit generate. Boom. This is what we get. ImageN4 allows you to generate very crisp, high-fidelity images, and I'm not going to lie, it does a very, very good job, especially with prompt adherence. Now, personally, I always prefer a front-facing image, not an angled one, not a side-on. I believe that a straight-on view gives you more control later on when we're going to start creating the variations. So I really like this one. I think it's perfect. We can clearly see the subject's face. We can see the castle in the background. We can see the outfit, all the visual cues that we need to maintain. As I said, be intentional. Details matter. And make sure that all these details are present in your prompt. You can use keywords like photorealistic, close-up, moody, blurred, etc. to control your generation, but I've also attached a PDF in the description with all the trigger words that you'll need for image generation in the future. Step number two, creating variations and consistent frames. Once we are happy with our source image, we download it, and we're going to use it inside Enhancor.ai to generate variations of this exact same image and build consistent frames, start telling a story. When you open up Enhancor, we're going to head over to Tools and click Context Editing. This is using Flux new context feature. This is where the magic happens. On the left, you'll see this section over here, and you're going to upload your source image, just one for now. In this case, we're going to upload the image we just downloaded. Then in the prompt section, we're going to describe exactly how you want this image to change. Do you want to change the angle? Do you want to change the character? Do you want the character to start running? Do you want a close-up image of this exact person? This is why it's called context editing. You're editing the image based on the context that you are providing in the prompt. So let's do a very simple one, for example. I'll write a close-up image of a woman. And boom, here it is. Same character, same location, same outfit, just a different camera angle. That's crazy, right? The magic here is in two things. First, the strong source image that we have selected. Second, the strong specific prompt. And here's my workflow for the prompts. I'll go into ChatGPT and I'll paste the original prompt that I used in ImageGen 4, and I'll ask, generate different angles of this photorealistic close-up photograph of a model in a foggy forest, one that is zoomed out, one that is full body shot, one that is from a side, and one aerial view. Now, ChatGPT will give me several variations, so I can paste those right into Enhancor to create a fully visual sequence. So I'm going to copy this right here. This one is a zoomed out portrait. So it says a photorealistic portrait of a model standing in a foggy forest shot from a medium distance. I'm going to copy this entire prompt and I'm going to paste it over inside Enhancor and hit generate. Yo, this is crazy. This changes everything, my friend. What if I want to generate a side angle? I'm going to do the exact same thing. Copy the prompt, paste it over, hit generate, boom. This is pretty cool. What if I want, let's say I want my character inside the castle? Well, same process. I'm going to ask ChatGPT to generate a matching prompt, same mood, same style. And you can even go further by asking it to generate an entire storyline for you following that prompt structure. So all you can do is copy the prompt and paste it in. So let's do it. A wide angle photorealistic photograph of a model standing inside a grand medieval hall. So I'm going to copy this, paste it, hit generate, easy. You need to start thinking in terms of a shot list. For example, wide establishing shots, maybe medium hero shots, tracking shots, where you can have the model running or any sort of movement. You can have over the shoulder shots, or you can have close-up shots, right? So yeah, when you prompt, think like a DP or a director. Like, how would they describe it to the cinematographer? You use simple terms like camera angles, lens choices, the movement, the lighting cues. These are going to be crucial for you to control the output. Step number three, adding props and creative control. If you want even more control, say you want your model to hold a specific object, right? Maybe you want the model to hold your product. You can do that too. So in context editing, in the same exact playground, we're going to click the plus button to add an additional image. For example, product photo. In this case, I'm going to use a lantern that I found online. And then I'm going to say something like a photorealistic portrait of a model standing in a foggy forest shot from a medium distance. She's holding a small red lantern. Have to specify that the lantern is small and that the lantern is red. Hit generate. Boom. And just like that, you've added a prop. This works with anything. You can have the model hold a Coke can. Let's try it out. Let's get an image of a Coke. Upload it over here and say a model holding a small red can. Hit generate. Boom. Done. The next thing that I do is that I upscale my favorite images. It's very simple. You download the image and you head over to Portrait Upscaler. You upload your image, and here you can choose between fast and professional modes. For important projects, I always go with professional, because it gives me a higher fidelity, higher resolution image. For example, all these images that you see right here were all upscaled inside Enhancor after they were generated with context editing. And here's all the prompts I used. Now let's upscale this image over here. This upscaler is phenomenal for portrait photography. It does very well with other use cases, but it is made for portrait photography, so keep that in mind. And here we have it. Before, after. And now here are all our frames. Take a look at them. Aren't you proud? This is phenomenal work. It's not only AI at work, but also you. It's your vision, your ideas. Always remember that. You working with AI. To go an extra mile, we can turn these into videos, right? And I use Kling 2.0, which does a phenomenal job at understanding camera motion. I can tell it to zoom in, to zoom out, fast forward. I can tell it that the video is handheld. Now, another thing you can do is generate audio and sound effects. You can use AudioX, that is a free open source model that allows you to generate audio from a single footage. So all you have to do is you head over and you upload your footage over here. You describe the mood, the vibe, or whatever that you want to generate. You hit enter, and boom. Here's the wind blowing. You can even create soundtracks. Listen up. So this, my friend, this is how you can create a consistent storyline or mood boards for your projects easier than ever, using Imagen 4 or your favorite image generation model and Enhancor AI. Now, you can do much more than just that. You can edit your images. For example, you can add snow, you can change hairstyle, outfit, but we will get into this in another video. I really appreciate you being here. And if you're interested in everything AI, from content creation to marketing to filmmaking, ads, AI SaaS, ComfyUI workflows, and more, I have a community where we also host weekly calls to learn and talk about the latest advancements in AI. I help you monetize your AI content and show you the best and latest methods of creating with AI. It is called AI for Pros because you are a pro. And this week, we're talking about creating AI thumbnails like these ones that you see on my YouTube channel. I'll see you there. But until then, create without limits. This is Sirio.